Oh, I didn't see you come in there. Greg Miller from Up at Noon, and here's an extended interview from the show. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's Glen Schofield, the man who made Modern Warfare 3 all by himself, these hands, right here. Yep. There they are. Thank you for being
on the
show.
It's been a long time. Thanks for having me, Greg. No, I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Now, Glen, I'm a bit confused. I read about this Modern Warfare today. It's a big deal. It seems like people know the game. Sold, made more than $1 billion in 16 days. However, I looked around YouTube, I only see comments about people hating it. Who's buying this game?
A lot of people are buying it. I guess the only ones that are vocal are the ones that don't like it.
Yeah. Well, they can get out of
mom.
Here. Yeah. The mom? The mom. You think the mom is coming onto YouTube?
Maybe.
And mad at their child for killing so many dogs. Yeah. Why do you guys hate dogs so much?
I don't know. We put in cats and it just didn't work.
Glen, you're in an interesting position with Modern Warfare 3. Because you're with Sledgehammer Games.
Right.
And this is your first time really coming onto the project.
Yes.
You want to tell me, what is Sledgehammer Games and then how did you guys get to this point?
Well, you know, we were a brand new studio for Activision. We've been making games a long time. I've been doing them like 20 years. You know, we just have to be in the right place at the right time.
How does that go down? Someone's walking by and like, I think I could make a gun. I'm really good at sights. I'd just be great to make a sight.
You know, a bunch of execs came up one day and said, you're making Modern Warfare 3. We're like, yeah, okay.
I guess.
You
know? There's worse jobs out there, right?
Yeah. Looked around, everyone said, that's cool.
But I mean, what about the pressure to do that, right? I mean, Call of Duty, obviously, even before this one, had already been, we're the biggest franchise, we're all of entertainment, yada, yada, yada. And so then they come to you and they're like, hey, come make this game with us.
Yeah, well, behind the scenes, we're not that cool.
Yeah.
It's pretty scary. I mean, this is a big one for us. And, you know, I think anybody who's working on it is going to have a little pressure. And, you know, we felt it, but that kind of thing just makes you, you know, work harder and, you know, being paranoid is actually a good thing when making video games.
Yeah.
It just, you know, put your mind to making something great. That's all that counts.
So for the people who are watching and don't know much about a development cycle, how does that work? Somebody comes to you and then months later, years later, what's happening? How does this all come together? Do they give you the plan or did you come to them with a plan?
Well, they come to you and, you know, of course we worked with Infinity Ward on that and, you know, those guys have been making it for, you know, since the beginning. And they're experts at it, and you know, so we just worked alongside with them, and you know, it's a complete co-development, and working together, we write the story, we, you know, we're on VidCons, we're on planes all the time, flying back and forth, working together, and we just have two great development teams that acted as one.
Now, Infinity Ward had been making the games for a long, long time.
Yes.
Why did they want to co-develop this time?
Well, they needed some more help. This was a very big game. I mean, you see all the content that we have in it, and. It just took a long time to make the game, and you know the games get bigger and bigger, and they take more and more support. You just need more help.
So you finish the game.
Yep.
You're getting ready to ship it, and at what point do you go, just, oh crap, we really can't screw this up? Because like I'm saying, for me, it's going to be news when Call of Duty doesn't sell more than the last Call of Duty. So like when they're like, oh, it's $1 billion, oh, big deal. $1 billion.
Yeah.
No, thank you, good sir. But I mean, like for you, like if this they would have all pointed at you.
Oh, absolutely.
Like, this one didn't sell. What the hell's wrong with you?
Oh, yeah. We knew that the whole time. So that's why we put the pressure on, and, you know, we told, you know, everybody on the team, you don't work hard, you don't make a great game, we'll kill you. I'm from Jersey, and that's just what we believe in.
Yeah. No, that's the Jersey motto?
Yes.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay. I work a guy named Brian Altano sometimes. Says the same thing to me before every one of these shows.
I think I saw him.
Yeah, no, he's far away in a Capcom office.
Okay.
It's all, there's a lot of satellites lining up to beam. It's
well,
long
that's what
story.
I meant.
Okay. Yeah, sure. Oh. Sure.
Yeah.
Okay, so the game comes out. It's a big deal. Like, what does that do for your studio? Are you guys onto another project, or what do you want to start working on?
Well, you know, we still have a lot of content to make. There's, you know, we've got that whole season of Modern Warfare 3 content.
Oh, that's right. There's some DLC for this game.
Yes.
The most recent, or the only so far content drop has come out recently.
Yeah, we had Liberation and Piazza that just came out, and we're going to be doing a lot more coming up.
Now, walk me through how the DLC plans work this time around. It's already out on Xbox. Because you hate the PlayStation 3.
I don't.
Oh, you don't. All right,
I love it.
All right. But no, so it's out on Xbox. Just
yes,
came out
it's
a couple
out
weeks
on Xbox,
ago. But it's not available to everyone, correct?
Not yet. I mean, this is, you know, for our elite premium people, this is what they will get first. They get the first drops. And then, you know, the PlayStation is right around the corner.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. Any day now. But what are the elite players? What is Call of Duty Elite?
Well, Elite was made, it's sort of a social platform that was built for Modern Warfare 3, specifically for the Modern Warfare and the Call of Duty franchises. And it allows you to, I mean, we've got content that's coming, monthly drops, and we've got, you know, you can get all your stats. We have competitions with prizes, you know, lots of stuff coming on. And if you're a Premium Elite member, which you have to pay for,
yeah.
But it's a very good deal because you get all of our you know, DLC for free.
Okay. So does
plus a lot of other content.
Like what?
I don't know. We're still making it.
Oh, you're still making it. Right? Yeah. I thought we were going to get a scoop here. And just now, does the bank still take your money, or do they just say, no, we're all full. We can't put any, put it in the walls of your house, man. It's not every game's like, man, we need to make our own social network.
Yeah, well, I don't know. The money truck still hasn't backed up to my house.
Oh,
yet,
okay,
you know?
Okay, yeah, yeah. So. All right, well, bunch of jerks.
I'm waiting.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. All right, so now elite members are getting it. However, how many elite members are in the audience right now?
Woo!
All right, there you go. Can you help these poor souls out?
Yeah, why not? All right, all of you are now premium elite members. We're going to give it to you for free. Yeah.
You're a man of the people, man.
That's with all the money we make.
You just backed the dump truck full of codes up to them and
yeah.
Let the DLC shower over them.
Let's just make sure they get it now.
Yeah, well, that's not our problem. Yeah, that's a producer problem.
Not either, yeah.
That's not a Greg Miller problem. So what's next? I mean, you're still working. There's a whole bunch of DLC still coming, right?
Yeah, yeah. We've got a you know, a plan, a huge plan out there, and we've been working pretty hard since we finished the game. It's funny, in the old days, you just finished the game and that was it. Now it's like, finish the game, you got DLC, you got patches, you got all kinds of stuff. And we've got a lot of, there were so many things that we weren't able to get in the game. You know, we had so many ideas. When you're done with a game, you've got a lot more you want to get in. So, you know, this sort of thing allows us to get some of the extended story, some of the different missions that we didn't get in, yeah, into the game. So you got a lot of special stuff coming up.
What are the missions? Tell me all the missions.
I can't really tell you.
Damn it, dude.
Well, we haven't necessarily
named them yet. This is the first episode. No one's going to watch this.
Yeah. Then why'd you have me on?
I'm trying to work out the kinks. Just get all the kinks.
So I'm a kink guy.
Yeah. You'll straighten me out.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, okay.
I'd give you a name and it would change anyway.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. Glenn, thank you so much for coming.
Well, thanks for having me, man.
Thanks for giving away cool stuff to the audience. Thanks again, Glenn. I hope you guys enjoyed the interview, and I hope you click here to watch the latest episode of Up at Noon, and then click here to subscribe to start, and then click here. No real reason, just because you like me.